We are here in the National Gallery of Art in D.C., where we find Descent from the Cross, done by Rembrandt Van Rijn. This work was done in the Netherlands with oil on canvas, which was a very popular medium in this time in 1634.
This was done during a time of religious unrest between the Catholics and the Protestants. The patron for this piece, as well as Rembrandt, were trying to portray the importance of religion and the power of God, and how he will help us if we just follow and believe in him. This piece shows the religious scene of Jesus Christ being taken down from the cross by his disciples, a very popular scene that many other artists have shown in their own way.
Key elements of this painting show us that this was a Baroque style piece. The drama and theatricality of the painting as a whole, as well as the individual faces within the scene. There is also the very prominent use of the Baroque light, or a sort of spotlight in this piece.
Yeah, so the spotlight singles out two people specifically. The first and most intense is that of Jesus Christ. Because of how extreme the lighting is, we can really see all the detail of the body that Rembrandt put in. When the light hits him, you can really see the bright white cloth he's wrapped in, as well as the bright red shirt of the man underneath him. His body is painted in a very realistic manner, with his body twisting and falling in an uncomfortable way, giving him a lifeless quality. When we look closer, we can see the marks from the thorn crown and where he was nailed into the cross on his hands and feet.
The second person in a spotlight is a woman on the right, who we can perceive as Mary. Her spotlight is slightly duller than the one on Jesus, since she is not the main focus of the piece. She is shown as having fainted and being held up by the people around her, mirroring the weight and helplessness of Jesus on the cross.
As we look around the painting at the other faces, we can see a variety of expressions that are full of emotion. This emotion is shown in the weeping and mourning of the woman and the inner unrest and sadness in the men.
Also, when we look around the painting, we can see various figures coming out slightly from the darkness in the background. Rembrandt used a technique called tenebrism, where darkness becomes a dominating feature of the painting, creating an air of drama in this very active composition. Within the composition, he also has a pyramidal-like structure where Jesus' hand is the tip.
This piece can be compared to the Elevation of the Cross by Peter Paul Rubens. They portray the opposite ends of the story of Jesus on the cross, but have similar compositional structures. The pyramid, for example, is prominent in both pieces. They are very different, however, and that we can see very clearly in the way the body is depicted. Rubens was influenced by Michelangelo, which gave the people in the painting very muscular and healthy bodies. Even Jesus, who should look emaciated if it was true to life. And Rembrandt's piece, as we have mentioned before, is much more realistic in the condition of the human body.
Overall, the Descent from the Cross gives off a sense of grief, but in a very dramatic way, such is common for the Baroque period. We feel it was successful, showing the need for religion in this time.